Bashar Assad uses different tactics in terms of the crackdown. He apparently made a decision early on with his brother. It's a family affair. They always consult and talk, within the family on how to carry out the crackdown. And apparently with the Iranians playing a role as advisors to them based on their own experiences in cracking down against the Green Movement a couple of years ago. So they came up with a strategy whereby they keep the killing to an extent, to a minimum, 20 people every day, 30 people, but not too much in order not to sort of rise international suspicions and attention. And they got away with it for a while. And they killed by means of snipers oftentimes. They position snipers in key locations in around the streets and around the communities that are rebelling, even though the protesters are unarmed completely, but they tell the troops that these are Salafis, these are jihadi elements, they are terrorists, you need to realize this is a conspiracy, a Zionist, American, imperialist conspiracy, all different sort of lies, just to gain the loyalties of the soldiers and convince them to fire at unarmed protesters. So they position snipers, the snipers kill a few people on every protest, just enough to disperse, the protests. But what happened is that people became bolder. They decided not to run away, even when they're facing guns. So the security people were sort of asked to open fire straight at the protesters now, and not simply snipers. They're relying basically on tanks. Sometimes tanks open fire, sometimes, they bombard with cannons the city. So the death toll began to rise. We expect that in 4 months of protests, around 2,000 people are killed and 20,000 people have been detained. But these numbers are expected to grow higher once we can actually have the ability to track every case. It's really a massacre that has been taking place in Syria in front of everybody. We try to document everything on YouTube, our videos, by cell phones, social networking sites. This is how we get information out of the country. But it's really extremely difficult to give an accurate picture of what's happening. And no matter how much information we're giving you, they don't really paint the horrors that the protesters are seeing every day and have to confront with every day.